Welcome to the MasterCars Pro channel. Today we will talk about the problems and weaknesses of this wonderful car. We're starting with the power units as usual. 1.1 liter, 1.3 liter and 1.5 non-turbo gasoline engines were available for MMC Colt 6. 1.5 turbo MIVEC and 1.5 DID diesel were also available. Engines are rather reliable but still have some disadvantages. 1-liter engine has poor dynamics, excessive noises and fuel consumption. ECU software and throttle body are the weakest components of this engine. 1.3-liter engine is the most popular one. Its durability, fuel and power efficiency were highly estimated. Radiator cooler fan, throttle body and injection coils can have issues at 70 to 90,000 km. Fuel system will require repairs if bad fuels are used. Fuel filter is changed in assembly with fuel pump and costs 300 euros. High vibration levels may be explained by engine mount wear and low RPM reasons. Alternator belt is flexible and needs regular tensioning as it begins to whistle. Hot starts at low temperatures show that the engine was not designed for cold weather operation. Piston rings get friction worn at 200,000 km causing oil burning. 1.5-liter engine is similar to 1.3-liter engine, and the only difference is in larger pistons. Problems remain the same. Valve clearance needs adjustment every 90,000 km. Turbo 1.5-liter engine is very powerful. It was installed on CZT versions only. This engine is not recommended for purchase as it might be often operated in full throttle mode, which can cause some problems. Diesel cars are pretty good in fuel economy. There were no diesel-powered Colts on Russian market. European cars have high kilometerage values and bad condition, so the engine can require some repairs. Sensitive fuel system can fail quickly after bad fuel use. 6th generation Colt was equipped with 5-speed manual and all-shift automated transmissions. Manual gearbox shows good durability. Its weaknesses are control links. Hard shifts are the signals to replacement. Automated transmission can get a lot of troubles. Kicks and shift delays are common. Reverse mode can be hard to turn on. Also, reverse mode can get disabled in motion. Control unit programming can help. If it does not, replace servo motor as its link get worn. Servo price is about 1000 euros, that is quite expensive. Unexpected shifts to neutral mode can be connected to right ABS sensor failure. It causes wrong data transfer to TCM. One more all-shift issue is its adjustment needed to increase clutch lifetime. First signals to clutch replacement are kicks at gear shifting and no motion if brake pedal released. CV joint seals have leakages on all the Colts. Suspension noises were common till 2008. Torsion bar mounts and links should be replaced every 40 to 70,000 km. Support bearings and rear shock absorbers are rather weak. Other components last for 120 to 150,000 km and more. Suspension repairs can require lots of expenses because assembly replacement will be needed. Steering system is also reliable. Steering knuckles last for 150,000 km, links live for 250,000 km. Steering rack is replaced in assembly with links. Brake system has some problems. Standard brake discs are worn and overheated easily. ABS sensor can melt down. Compact exterior impressively combines with plenty of interior space. Glove compartment has a weak lock, so its cover may have to be replaced. Rear mountings can get loose if disconnected frequently. Handbrake fixes can break. Electrics and electronics may have multiple upsets. Window lifters and heater motor may fail. Onboard computer display can have multiple errors. Diode lightening or processor resoldering can help. CRS errors occur if steering wheel contact group becomes worn. Resoldering usually helps. Paint job is done in Japanese style and is pretty soft. Lots of scratches and paint damages appear on car bodies. Body metal has good rust resistance though. Well, if you are the owner of this car, then please describe the problems that you had to face during the operation of the car. Perhaps it is your feedback that will help viewers when choosing a car. That's it for today. Thanks everyone for attention. It isn't much work for you to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.